Hi, I'm Nick from Pump Products. Today we're going to be changing the bearing assembly on a B&G 100 series three-piece circulator. What a bearing assembly is essentially that. It's just got a bearing in the center, as well as a shaft, and then the impeller on the end. So the tools you're going to need to do this are going to be a 7/16 combination wrench, 5/8 combination wrench, and an Allen key. So basically what you're always going to want to do is make sure the power is off to the pump as well as the water flow. So we're going to start by removing the motor using the 7/16 wrench. I'm going to use the box ends and just start popping this loose. There's going to be four bolts, so we're just going to go around. Now chances are yours will already be installed in piping. You won't have to remove the pump from piping. So you may need just a second hand to hold some parts for you as you take them apart. Now before you can completely remove the motor, there is a small spring style coupler in most of these pumps. Well, in all these pumps. Basically what this does is it makes the connection from the shaft of the motor to the shaft of the bearing assembly of the pump, causing the impeller to turn, getting you the water flow. So all you need is the hex key here. You're gonna pop it right in, unscrew it. All right, so as you can see, there's a small indentation on the shaft of where the coupler will go, the hex screw of the coupler. And there's gonna be one on the other side as well. Can't really get a good view, but it's right in there. So we're gonna put the motor to the side for now. We're gonna remove the other side of the coupler, unless you purchased a second coupler to replace. And what you could do, just run your hex key right into one of the holes here and just unscrew it. So next we're going to remove the actual bearing assembly using the 5/8 wrench. And you're just going to remove the bearing assembly from the volute of the pump. So you're just going to remove the casing gasket. Just make sure that this area right here is nice and clear, devoid of any imperfections. You may have to run a little bit of acetone or alcohol wipes just to kind of clean it up if it's a little rusty or dirty. And this is going to be our new bearing assembly. We chose the one that includes the impeller. It's not the maintenance-free model, so you will have to add oil. And this is your new casing gasket. And that's the context of the box. Simply what we're gonna do, pop on the new casing gasket. Put on the new bearing assembly. Holes. And now you're just going to tighten everything up. There's a little piece of cardboard just on the shaft end of the bearing assembly. You're just going to want to remove that, slide it right off. We're going to install the coupler to the shaft of the bearing assembly, and we're just going to make sure the hex screw goes over the indent for the hex screw. Next, what we're going to want to do is reattach the coupler end to the motor shaft. And we're gonna find that indentation, as you can see right here. You'll know if the indent is not lining up with your hex screw because you'll have a large amount of the hex screw still sticking out. This I know went in, it's all the way flush to the face of the coupler. As you can see, it's not sticking out at all. And then from there, what we're gonna do is simply just reconnect the motor to the pump. So we're just gonna go ahead and tighten these down. Because this is not making a watertight seal, you don't exactly have to do the crisscross pattern, but you're more than welcome to if you want to. Finally, what you're gonna wanna do before you turn on your pump, run any water through it, anything, just wanna pop up this little flapper right here and use the contents of this oil. Just pour it completely in there till there's no oil left. or it starts to dribble out. And then all you're gonna do, turn on the water, turn on the electricity, and your pump's all set. Thank you for watching our video. If you liked our videos, please subscribe. Leave any comments below on any videos you might like to see next. And if you have any questions, please feel free to contact any of our experts at 800-429-0800, and we will be happy to help you.